foreword by Dr. Mustafa Mahmoud.
In the introduction to my book, A Traveler in Allah's World, I previously mentioned that religion has an essential reality, which can be described as the ancient love that we bore with us into this world. I refer to the permanent longing that fills our hearts, a longing for the original home from which we came, and to the spiritual thirst that overwhelms our feelings with eagerness for the spring from which we stem. This craving is veiled and concealed from us by the misfortunes, concerns, and desires of this worldly life. When I wrote about this, I was depending on my own sense of it without having any definite proof. But having seen this great book and having read the simple and sublime scientific-philosophic dialogue that went on between Sir John Bennett and the scholar Mohammed Amin Sheikho, I knew for certain that what I had sensed in my own depths was in fact proven by the amazing and wonderful logical proof offered by the scholar Sheikho. This human spirit has given birth to a great thing, trust, which the heavens, the earth, and the mountains feared and refused to bear. This took place before our coming to the present life, which is like a school that was prepared by Allah for the teaching of success and great salvation. Verily, that which the scholar reveals to Sir John Bennett in this dialogue is exactly what I have been looking for throughout my life, for I read the books of all the philosophers, the Greek, Roman, Muslim, and the Western, finding that none could approach the truth in the scholar's research or could explain the difference between the spirit and the soul, between thought and the mind, until I was acquainted with the perfect reality in this book, through which all the problems were made clear to me, as they had been made clear to Sir John Bennett before me. Indeed, the savant Mohammed Amin Sheikho focuses on the spirit and is concerned with it because the Holy Quran stresses it and is concerned with it. All Quranic verses address the spirit, instruct it, and guide it to the path of righteousness in order to be able to prostrate itself and come near to Allah. Thus, the Holy Quran as a whole is an address to this human spirit. Many people take an interest in everything. They concern themselves in building, clothing, eating, and drinking. They leave no domain without having a great share of interest in it all. All of which is related to the perishing body, which will end up as dust. But as for the spirit, they know nothing of it. They take care of the peel and forget about the everlasting true marrow and are blind to it. They taste nothing of godly love and are deprived of prostration before Allah the Almighty and being near to Him. Without the book of Allah the Almighty, we lack reality, wisdom, and nobility. Most of our sight clings to passing and perishing things in order to partake in pleasures of the body. In his verses, our provider indicates that this body will one day separate from the spirit and end up in the earth from which it was created, and moreover, it will bear witness against this spirit on doomsday, when it shall deny its deeds. God says in the Holy Quran, 4:41, Fussilat explained, verse 20, At length when they reach it, the fire, their hearing, their sight, and their skins will bear witness against them as to all their deeds. There were those who did not think that their hearing, sight, skin, hands, and legs would testify against them one day, but instead they believed that Allah the Almighty was far from them and did not know what occupied their spirits. It was such false belief which caused them to fall into corruption and then to be destroyed. How could they have had knowledge when they did not recognize themselves and when their chief concern in the present life was this body and no more? Therefore, you shall find the speech of the savant Sheikho, who is one of the reformers and admonishers, wondrous and strange if you do not recognize yourself. Who are you? What were you before you came to this world? For what did you come, and where are you going after death when you leave your body? But the most magnificent thing is to find the scholar Sheikho draws our attention to the water we drink and to the sources of those huge springs, such as the springs of the Nile River and the other big and small rivers on this earth. I became even more amazed when I read the consecutive scientific evidence which demonstrated that the North and South Poles are the sources of these springs. What a great scientific discovery, in which the scholar Mohammed Amin Sheikho preceded all geologists and astronomers despite all their achievements in scientific progress at this time. How near was he to Allah the Almighty so that he understood and witnessed those water passages through which water flows constantly and in strict order to reach our drinking cups and jugs without which we cannot live? In fact, that is what made me say in full truth, verily, the scholar Mohammed Amin Sheikho is a man who received revelations from our provider, and his science is truly derived directly from Allah. God says in the Holy Quran, Fortress 2, Al-Baqarah, the cow, verse 282, be under Allah's light, and then it is Allah that teaches you. This noble verse manifested in this man as a firm truth, for he turned heads with his explanation of difficult issues, especially those which are raised in the West about the precepts of Islam in its everyday situation. These precepts appear to them as problems, such as the cases of the veil, divorce, and polygamy. Besides, there is his scientific detailed demonstration of the seven heavens and the 6 days mentioned in the Holy Quran. So we are indebted to him for this science, for he dislodged from our shoulders the weight of worry from all the cases which we considered to be puzzles that were difficult to solve. Dr. Mustafa Mahmoud, Cairo, on the 29th of January 2000.